Alan, lads and lasses, it's Greg here at Bayek, Prentice Yorkshire Collective, and today I'm in York. I'm currently outside the station and I'm going to take you for a little wander around the city. Hope you enjoy the day. So we're at one of the highest points on the city walls here, looking over towards the Minster. It's a bit sheltered by the trees there, but we'll get a bit closer to take a closer look at it. Down below us here, it's a Lendal Bridge. This is the Lendal Bridge. About 2 years or 18 months ago, the York City Council decided that this bridge was getting too busy during the daytime. So they started a levee system, whereby if you came across this bridge during the daytime at specified hours, you would be fined if you hadn't already paid the levy charge. Such a shambles was the system that within 6 months the system had been scrapped and the council ended up paying out far more than they ever collected in levies and fines. So now we know why York is famous for shambles. So this is the entrance to the Museum Gardens and the Yorkshire Museum. Lovely August day. Plenty of people around. Enjoying a rare bit of summer sun. Display go here. Is what would have been the first abbey on this side. So I'm just at the foot of the Minster here. Taking a walk, get a bit closer. Take a walk around the shopping areas of York, starting at High Petergate. And they're named after the most famous resident of York, Guy Fawkes. He famous of the gunpowder plot, 1605. Thank you. Yeah, we'll take a walk past the gate. On right here, little Betty's cafe tea rooms. With a cake and bread shop in the front. Cafe on the upper floor. This is one of the original tailor's tea rooms before Betty's bought out tailor's in 1963. At the end of Stonegate here is, I think it's called St Helen's Square, and here we'll find the Big Betty's cafe in Tiro. It's very popular with American airmen during the Second World War. And the lower floor, the basement floor here, is set to be based on the interior of the Queen Mary luxury liner. Betty's brand has become synonymous with luxury, high quality, and expense. Not the cheapest cup of tea you'll get in this town. Just look at the queue. Get queues like this from 9 o'clock in the morning to probably 7 o'clock in the evening. All just so that people say they visited Betty's. So this is the main shopping area in York City Centre. And like most modern British city centres in the UK, it's dominated by the high street brands. It's alright. Banks and building societies. Opticians. Disney store. Thornton's Chocolates, premier chocolate brand here in the UK. Particularly Yorkshire, I think. Pret-a-Manger. So as you'd expect, most of the high street brands. We will take a little trip off the beaten track in a few minutes. Up to the most famous shopping area in York, which is known as Shambles. original 16th century Tudor buildings. We'll go take a browse at those in a minute. First, I'm going to take a look at Coppergate Centre and the Jorvik Viking Museum, which is just at the end of this road. We'll take a look at some street entertainment first. A bit of beatboxing. So this is Coppergate. Again, mostly dominated by the usual high-street brands. Coffee shops, shoe shops. Here we have Fenwick's department store, quite a high-end department store, something akin to John Lewis really. I only know of two branches, this one here in York and one in Newcastle. Mixed with Fenwick's, Primark, different end of the spectrum. And they've even built a beach here in the middle of Coppergate for the summer. Beginning of the Shambles Market. We'll take a look through. Busier towards the weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I hope it does. Markets deserve to be busy. A lot of work goes into running a market stall. Streets don't make it easy to walk and hold the camera steady at the same time. I think we'll be doing some image stabilisation when it comes to the edit. Original Tudor buildings. And really, a world away from the rest of the shopping area, which is full of high street brands. This certainly isn't. Artisan bread shop. If the shambles wasn't small enough, there's little shambles. So good to see that this maintains its original character. Absolutely no. High street plants. Apart from one, what a spoiler. Edinburgh will number, you have to go and spoil it. But apart from that, the rest of these shops are all independent.
Bye.
slowly. Up here. I'll slow back to Yorkshire, Roman Bath. And apparently there is still a Roman Bath buried on the site, maybe. Love York and all its little nooks and crannies. Thousands of little side streets, alleyways, snickets or ginnels as we call them in Yorkshire. Buildings in this area, fantastic. My mind, just a shame that they give it over to basically all the big chain restaurants, fashion stores. It'd be much nicer to see them as independents, but I guess it's just the big names, big brands that can afford the rent in this sort of area of a city like York. Because it can't be cheap. Take this right. Ooh, fine. That looks like a good idea. I'll have to go to lunch first though, I think. We've made it back to Stonegate. I think this has got to go down as a hidden gem. This is a riverside cafe bar, which is part of the city cinema complex. Lovely views over the river towards Lendal Bridge there. City cruise up the River Ouse. Oh, I don't know. Got waving. Norwich Union, now a Aviva building, Aviva headquarters in York. This is a independent cinema here in York. It's called the City Screen Picture House. It looks very nicely off Davy Gate. And here we have St Martin's Church. York is the second seat of the church in the UK, so I should expect there's plenty of churches in the area. Lots and lots of ancient churches. this looks like it might be one of the older ones. Head back towards the paper gate. Ooh, Starbucks. So here on Davy Gate, it's mainly the usual high street stores. So we'll give that this. So I've taken a little walk up the side of the River Foss, behind the Coppergate Centre and Phoenix Department Store. And I've come out here at Clifford's Tower. Okay, so take a little walk along the riverside. Let's head back to the station. Up here, the King's Arms. It's renowned for flooding when the river gets high, gets too high, when it swells. As it often does. Certainly the cellars of the pub. And often the bar itself. I'm submerged in water. the rear of the Riverside Cafe and Bar with the City Screen Cinema that I showed you earlier. St Martin's Church in the background there. Seem to enjoy themselves basking in the sun. Just come off the end of Lindell Bridge again. We're heading back towards the station. Concludes my little trip around York. I'm here at the York Tap at the railway station. I'm going to have a quick pint before I get back on my train. Until next time, I'll see you later.